diseases of jackfruit. Now we will see the list of important diseases in jackfruit. So my name is N. Shankar Reddy and I am doing PhD plant pathology in Annamalai University. So these are all the list of important diseases in jackfruit. First one is pink disease, which is caused by Pelicularia salmonicolor, and dieback, which is caused by Botryoplodia theobromae, foot rot, Rhizopus atrocarpi. The first one is pink disease, which is caused by Pelicularia salmonicolor. And the name itself indicates pink disease, in the sense pinkish discolorations can be seen on leaves and as well as in young branches. We can see pinkish discoloration can be seen on leaves and as well as young branches. This pinkish discoloration or this fungus further penetrates inside the bark. We can see here this fungi further penetrates inside the bark and grows inside the cortex. So due to this, what will happen, the nutrients, it blocks the completely, it blocks the transport of nutrients as well as the minerals or water whatever the required by the plants. Due to that, yellowing of leaves can be seen observed on the upper surface, and yellowing of leaves and as well as crinkling, and later stages the plant will slowly dies. The main reason to call it as a pink disease, pinkish color discoloration can be seen on leaves and as well as young branches. So coming to the management aspects, removing the affected plants, affected branches as well as applying of Bodo paste at cut end can be one of the management practice. Coming to second disease, dieback, which is caused by Botryoplodia theobromae. On the right side, we can see the symptoms can be observed on affected leaves and affected fruits also we can see. So the affected leaves are normally brown color discoloration and marginal rolling can be seen. Brown color discolorations, small brown color discoloration and rolling of leaves can be seen. But the major important symptoms are major damage caused to fruits because a blackish color fungus growth or brown color fungus growth can be clearly seen. The entire fruit is rotten completely in the black color fungus growth that can be completely covered with completely covered the fruit. If we cut open the fruit, we can see the complete rottening and the mycelium which disintegrate the internal fruit areas, internal fruits. This fruit or this Botryoplodia infected fruit is completely unfit for consumption. Moreover, if you see the inside areas, exudates are gummy like substances are exudates from the infected plant, infected fruits, and discoloration of leaves also that will be very common. But they coming to the infected fruits, we can clearly see the blackish fungi that covers the blackish blackish fungal growth can be covers the fruit in jackfruit. So coming to the management aspects, pruning the infected plant parts, that is followed by application of carbendazim 0.1% and application of chlorothalonil 0.2% can be recommended, and the controlling of shoot borer or short hole borers can be one of the management practices for controlling this insect vectors. These insects we can recommend insecticides, and also helpful for reducing the incidence of dieback disease that also happens in jackfruit. So coming to the third one, fruit rot or soft rot is a very very important one, which is caused by Rhizopus atrocarpi. So coming to the, we can clearly see the size of the fruit is greatly reduced. The size of the fruit, it doesn't grow more than 2 to 3 inch, and along with a black color mycelial growth or blackish to white color mycelial growth completely covers the entire fruit. And the major symptom is mummification of fruits. The size of the fruits, let us consider how big the jackfruit is. But here, if you see this size, it doesn't grow more than 2 to 3 inch, or doesn't grow more than a size of a finger. Let us imagine how damage it causes to the jackfruit. So moreover, along with the mummification, white color mycelial growth, if we examine in microscope, we can clearly see the spores of Rhizopus along with the stalk like appearance, along with the central columella, and as well as the spores can be seen in sporangia. And coming to the management aspects, improve sanitation and spraying of Bodomycete 0.4% or copper oxychloride concentration at the rate of 0.2% can be recommended. So coming to the questions related to ARS or NET other exams, causal organisms are very 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 important. Pink disease, very important one, and I had seen it in many areas. And moreover, this Rhizopus root rot, which is caused by Rhizopus atrocarpi, the causal organism very 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 important. and many exams I had seen this question. So causal organisms are the most important parts in this jackfruit. So this is about jackfruit.